Welcome to By Pistis Blog. Overcome IT. You can overcome it even though certain days contradict your confidence to believe. You won't be the first to do it and you can lead the way. It always sounds easy, but listen to David's testimony to victory. Recognize what's oppressing you. Sometimes, you will face something in life and not understand what it is, why, or if there's something you did to open that door. So many have found themselves in the same predicament and you won't be the last. Those before you found their victory and you will too. Is it easy? No, but it is possible. Whether you're a believer of Christ or not, you are an overcomer. Evil doesn't care who and what you believe in when it strikes. One thing is for sure, you have to believe and remain confident. You have the right to show up every day and live the life given to you. No one has the right to disrupt your life by any means, whether it's spiritual or natural battles, and you have to know this. Your adversary counts on you being silent and seeing it as permission to continue oppressing you. Having great support, a person you can trust, and who believes that what you're facing is real. Belial Pursed David. David in the Word of God was known as a mighty king and warrior. Chosen by God, influential, powerful, and committed. Who in their right mind would oppose David to the point that he would have to seek assistance from his spiritual father? You will find David in Scripture praying against the sons or daughters of Belial. You may not have heard of these spiritual battles that show up through people that you come in contact with daily. Whether it's a spouse, unfriendly friend, relative, spiritual leader, or sister and brother of Christ or stranger, the same battle David fought is still plaguing the land. There is hope, and you will overcome. So many are unaware of this type of behavior and have a hard time believing that this charming personality has become an overnight extreme nightmare. Identify Belial and overcome. Belial isn't nice and doesn't play fair. Belial looks like intimidation, control, manipulation, bullying, harassment, narcissism, astral projection, witchcraft, lies, greed, fear, abuse, gaslighting, assassination of character, and deception. According to the Word, it comes to steal, kill, and destroy other people's lives, John 10 verse 10. The good news is that your spiritual father came so that you may have life more abundantly. Belial shows up in different personalities and they are very cunning. Belial camouflage their wickedness behind smiles, false promises, religion, and friendly disposition. Like Eve, Belial can slither into your life like the serpent pretending to have your best interest to only catch you with your guard down. Belial loves to separate you from your support systems and divide families and friends so they can be the loudest voice, the biggest influence in your life, and control. David knew better and he knew not to play with it, so he went into battle. Subdue and overcome. You need confidence, faith, belief, and the Word, which is the sword of the Spirit. For some, they have to also get therapy and legal help to break free, so always do what's best when you face these types of situations. Become more aware so you can identify when these types of personalities show up and how to avoid them from staying in your life. Like David, he recognized that Belial was a wicked spirit operating through people and he needed reinforcement from his spiritual father. The Word suggests meditating day and night on the Word, and the fervent prayer of the righteous availeth much. Don't be afraid to stand up for yourself and seek protection always. Know that you're beautifully and wonderfully made and you deserve total happiness and freedom. You can and will overcome. Stay focused, diligent, and hopeful. You're not alone. From a spiritual standpoint. In life, You cross paths with all types of personalities, and not all personalities are bad. However, you can't deny the fact that evil has been around for ages. Spiritual battles operate through individuals who open themselves up to be used to hurt others. You hear of the stories and never know when you will experience them yourselves. The word says that people perish for a lack of knowledge, so secure your toolboxes with the necessities for a healthy and balanced life. You can't help who you cross paths with, but you can do your part to avoid it without being fearful. Your spiritual father called you to walk in love and love your neighbor as yourself. Some measuring tools to use are comparing character and behavior with the character of your spiritual father, being treated in love, paying attention beyond the mask that some people wear, what's the motives, and listening carefully to what's being said versus what's being done, and praying about everything. Does their behavior line up with the word? Never make decisions out of desperation. Seek help and educate yourself. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we appreciate the one reading this blog today. We pray that it brought awareness to many so they will know how to avoid and protect themselves from toxic and unhealthy situations. We pray that you will increase their discernment and give them wisdom beyond their years. Release a peace that surpasses all understanding, and we pray they remain strong and confident. Go before them each day, removing the stumbling blocks, filling the potholes, and placing detour signs to avoid in the wrong direction. Cover them in your love and continue to light up their path. They are stronger than they realize, and most of all a true overcomer. Keep them hidden under the shadow of your wings and in the palm of your hands as they navigate the rest of their lives. By faith. Thank you for listening. Please subscribe to this channel and visit bypistisblog.com for more content.